Okay, good morning. So, we were looking at the stability of an air parcel, correct? So, we are looking at the stability of an unsaturated air parcel and so on. And we have to move on to stability of saturated air parcel, okay? As you know, the transition from unsaturation to saturation takes place basically by knowing the lifting condensation, lifting condensation level. Beyond that, there is something called the level of free convection, LFC, which we will see in today's class. But before that, the first few minutes, I thought that the problem number 38, which was involving a Chinook wind. As you know, the Chinook wind is the snow, it is called the snow beater, where cold winds are blowing from one side of the ocean. They hit the mountains, they climb. Once they cross a lifting condensation level, they shed the moisture in the form of precipitation, and they, because of the winds, they cross the other side, the air parcel crosses the other side, and then it follows a dry adiabatic. And then when it reaches the 1000 hp, we have seen that it becomes much more hotter than it originally started out with. So, the leeward side of the mountain, you got dry hot winds, okay, which can melt snow. So, it is called a snow beater. So, it is particularly prevalent in Canada and in the US, for example, in Colorado and so on, alright. So, this problem we have already solved using this QT Lon P chart. I thought that I will just show you an animation today, okay. Then, so you have already solved this. So, let us go through this, okay. The problem number 38. So, these pink lines are the isotherms, it's QT Lon P. So, it is a QT Lon P chart. Now, initially we have a temperature T1 is 30 degrees centigrade. Temperature T1 is 30 degrees centigrade and the pressure is 1000 hp, I am sorry, it is 1000 hp. So, that is point A. So, it is indicated by the blue lines, sorry, yellow lines. So, the pressure is horizontal and the temperature is the skewed straight line. So, the intersection gives you the point A. Superimpose the saturation mixing ratio on this. Now, the mixing ratio has been given to be 14 grams per kg. Now, find out where for this omega is equal to omega s, where it hits the 1000 hp at the same pressure level, that will be the dew point, okay. Then you draw a line which goes along the saturation mixing ratio of 14, it is going up, that is the yellow line, right, okay. Now, from the original point A, take a dry adiabat and it is going up. So, the saturation mixing ratio corresponding to omega equal to omega is equal to 14 grams per kg will meet this curve of dry adiabat, which is originating from the original point A, and this intersection gives you the LCL, very good. So, LCL is 840 hp. Any doubt so far? It is fine, okay. So, it gives you, so you find the lifting condensation level. Next, these are the saturation adiabats. Okay, saturation adiabats. So, after a parcel crosses the LCL, when it further climbs, its dharma is, it will follow the saturated adiabat, okay. Now, that is indicated by this line, okay. Now, when you put that line back into the 1000 hp, you actually get the wet bulb temperature, right. And this wet bulb temperature is also the potential wet bulb temperature because it is 1000 hp. Suppose my original condition were to be 950 hp, then you will pull this yellow line back to the 1000 hp, and that you will call it as theta W. But when it crosses the original, if it is 950, that will be the TW. So, if the original pressure is not equal to 1000 hp, TW will not be equal to theta W. But in this case, since the original pressure is 1000 hp, which is normal, therefore, the theta W is equal to TW. Any doubt so far? So, already we found so many quantities, all right. I think we solved a problem like this in the quiz, right. Next, it goes we have drawn one more horizontal line, which is the 700 HPA, correct? Because it rises up to 700 HPA. That is a point. So that is a maximum height it has reached, 700 HPA. You can take P by P naught is e to the power of minus z by h. I have a scale height of 7.5 kilometers. You can actually find out the height. Did we find out? We didn't find out. Okay, let's not. Huh?
We didn't.
Let us not agonize it further. So it will be some height. Okay, some kilometers it will have. It will be some kilometer. From there, I am drawing another 720. What does how do I get the 720? Because it is coming back. When it is coming back from 700, it will follow the saturated eddy path. And that is the point. Once it has come to 720, now it will follow a dry adiabat all the way up to 1000 HPA. So that will be the pink line. It will follow the pink line. It will again cut the 1000 HPA. That will be the final temperature, which is 35 degrees Celsius. So we have solved the complete problem on this QT ln P chart. So from the original condition, we found all the things. Dew point, wet bulb temperature, lifting condensation level, final height. Then you from the fine based on this point when it reaches the final height, you know what will be the mixing ratio, then what is the original mixing ratio, that will be saturation mixing ratio, the remaining must be shed or it must be held as water, 80% is removed, what is remaining will be 10.8, 14 minus 80% of 4, so 10.8 is remaining, with that 10.8 you are going all the way, then you got the final temperature 35, you can still calculate the relative humidity, I think it is drier, correct? The original relative humidity was 45 or 50%, now it has become 25 or 20%. How much was it? 24%. So this is the way I expected you to have solved in the quiz paper. Anyway, I will start looking at it over the weekend. Hopefully you are all now experts in using this QT ln P chart. Alright. Now this QT ln P chart we can get really involved. Now you can see that if I give you a sounding data, various pressures and heights, then finding the stability of the air layer and all that, it is more and more involved. This is what meteorologists routinely do every day in their sitting in their offices. Okay. I do not know how much deep we can go because we still have radiation, climate change, all those things, but I want to finish this week or next week maximum first class thermodynamics and get on to radiative heat transfer. I think we got too deep into the, okay. That is okay, I think we will see. Did it tell you about the saturated air also? No. So the Brunt-Weissala frequency, which we derived in the last class, is a measure of the stability of the air parcel. Greater the Brunt-Weissala frequency, better is the stability. Alright, because that gives you an idea of the restoring force and all that. We actually derived it from first principles. Brunt and Weissala are the two meteorologists who worked on this problem. That is why it goes by the name Brunt-Weissala frequency. Now, for saturated air, what is this now? Gamma less than gamma s is? Gamma less than gamma d was stable or not? For the unsaturated? Yes. So it is positive static stability. It is negative static stability. If it is this, it is neutral stability. Okay. Let's solve a problem now. Problem number 39. 41, okay. After that we solved 2, is it? Oh, we derived the Brunt-Weissala, okay. So problem number 41, okay, we will easily cross the half century. So if you have solved 50-55 problems and then 6 to 8 problems in the quiz and some 10 problems in the NSEM, you would have solved some 70 problems. So that is actually the learning, according to me, maximum learning. Theory you will forget. So if you have solved 60 or 70 problems, that means it is a good foundation. It does not mean that you know everything in atmospheric science, but next time you take a book, it is easy for you to follow and you can build on it. Okay, that is the whole idea. A layer of unsaturated air flows over a mountain. A layer of unsaturated air flows over a mountain where the ridges, the gaps, where the ridges are 11 kilometers. They are 11 kilometers in the flow direction. Gamma the lapse rate is 5.5 Kelvin per kilometer and T is 25 degrees. Okay. For what value of the wind speed V will the period of terrain induced oscillations because of the ridges, some oscillations will be induced, right? For what value of the wind speed V will the terrain induced oscillation, will the terrain induced forcing, you can take oscillation stroke forcing, match the period of the buoyancy oscillation. Getting the question? For what value of the wind speed will the period of terrain induced oscillation or forcing match the period of the buoyancy oscillation? Okay. Just calculate, it will take a couple of minutes. This is also called orographic oscillation. Orography is the effect of topography, particularly in relation to mountains. If you have mountain gaps and all that, that can also induce some oscillation. Orographic for example, when we do high resolution monsoon calculations, or you, for example, I am trying to track cyclone, for example, Hud, which came yesterday, if you want to track the Hud, so the possibility is whether in your model you will include the Western Ghats or not. Though it is on the Bay of Bengal, we do not know. So you will have to look at the model with and without Western Ghats and see the difference. The Western Ghats can be 2-3 kilometers. But generally, I do not expect in that case it will be severely affected by the Western Ghat. But if you do a monsoon calculation over Bombay without the Western Ghats, you will get all junk answers, correct? Because Western Ghats are significant, 2.5 to 3 kilometers height. So this is called the effect of orography. And the effect of orography, the problem is the topography is not always updated and it is always changing. So we use some topography data which is 30 years old. In 30 years, we do not know how much it has changed. So we have to do survey. So we have to depend on surveyors to find out what is the, so you have to get latest topography updates in order that you, so atmospheric calculations will involve so many things. You need to know exactly the salinity of water, because the emissivity of water is a function of the salinity. and the emissivity of the water will decide the radiation force, which will decide the dynamics also, because radiation will be a term in the energy equation. So it's all very complicated, but let's stick to the story. So problem number 41, you will do the simple, calculate the oscillation, terrain induced oscillation and the buoyancy induced. So which means first calculate the Brunt-Weissauer frequency. All right. I am circulating some paper. Where is it now? So today we have to finalize. Do not decide anything, just do inky pinky pongy, decide on the topic, decide on the partner, and then be done with it. Okay. I will freeze and then in the next few days I will send an email. November 15, 9 o'clock. Somebody has an NSM at 2 o'clock, whatever, you have to come. 9 o'clock, you come and finish. If your NSM is 9 to 12, you come at 12:15. If your NSM is 2 o'clock, come at 9. And all the present, you have to divide, if there are 3 people, if it is 12 or 15 minutes, 5 minutes, 5 minutes, 5 minutes, all of you must present. And you should not run away when the other two are presenting, and you should not run away when other groups are also present. All right? Okay, so what is this now, solution? What is gamma d? How much is it? 9.8, 9.7. Okay. All right. Temperature is 298. So the Brunt-Weissauer frequency is real. Yeah, right. What is that? 5? What did I give? Watch out! Watch out! Watch out! Watch out! It is Kelvin per kilometer into. Is it correct? -3 or +3? Here. Correct? Orographic oscillation is so the time period is L by V. kilometers, 11 into 1000 divided by V. All right, then (2π/N). All right, now 11 into 1000 is known, this is known, this is known, you have to find V. Marius, is it okay? So as simple as that, the N is coming from the buoyancy, because we are going to match this buoyancy with the orographic. So what is the value you are getting? 20.8. Very good, 20.8, that's what I am getting. Okay, so if you are having a wind velocity of 20.8 meters per second, you may be in trouble. Huh? Something will happen, right? This is air parcel and this thing, and some resonance will take place and some other atmospheric phenomena, maybe, right? So there will be, so the 20 meters is a critical speed for this case. 20 meters is a little high, but it is not that high. It can happen sometime. Okay. Now, if you have high static stability, with negative lapse rates, okay, let us talk about temperature inversion. What is the temperature inversion? The temperature inversion is that is generally not on. Where is it happening in the atmosphere from the original profile? It is happening in the troposphere or stratosphere or stratosphere. So lighter layers are above. If it is hotter at the top, if you take a layer, it is hotter at the top, it is lighter, okay. So if it is colder, it will come down. So it will be stratified, that is why it is stratosphere. If it is stratified, it will stay there for a long time. So if in a jet, you just pollute the atmosphere with the carbon dioxide, that carbon dioxide will stay there in the stratosphere for a long time. So this pollution, and also lot of the cyclonic cyclone may take place, lot of this rain activity will not take place at that altitude, because the rain activity is the first few kilometers in the troposphere. So if, to cut a long story short, if you put something up in the stratosphere, already the situation is that the it is stratified, so that cleansing will not take place so easily in the stratosphere. Are you getting the point? That is why if you put something in the stratosphere, it will take a long time, okay, right? But this, are you getting the point? No, that it will not come back. The air parcel will be there. No, how will it come back? It will not flush out that CO2 because of its temperature profile. Because of its temperature profile, the hotter is above, the hotter is less dense, so it will stay like that. When will convection take place? When the denser is above the lighter. When the lighter is above the denser, it is fine. So only if it comes back, then it can be washed by the oceans, water, it will go to the somewhere, it will get mixed with carbonic acid, nothing will happen. So it will stay like that. That is why we give the name stratosphere. It is stably stratified. It is stratified. So we should be careful that we don't inject lot of pollutants in the stratosphere. Okay. Now, we have seen all this. The saturated air also, we have seen the stability and all that. But what if this parcel keeps rising and it crosses the LCL? We have seen that problem number 38. From 840 it went all the way up to 700. How do we handle the, how do we know whether it is stable or not? Once, okay, if lot of instability is there, some convection will break out, which is good for us. We are always looking for instabilities. If the convection breaks out, it's a rain. So we, as a meteorologist, we want to know whether it will break out and this thing, and but there are other factors. But now, based on the sounding, can you say, sounding means temperature versus height, can you say something about the conditional stability? So now we have to go deeper and look at what is called conditional and convective instability. Okay, that is the next one. So I will use the full board. Is this fine? Let us consider the height versus temperature. So please pay attention, there is some involved, I am going to talk about some involved concepts now. Let us say that this is gamma. So the gamma is obtained from the sounding. Correct. Now, always our original point, the starting point is some O. Okay. Now, this is gamma S. Lapse rate for saturated air. Saturated air parcel. Okay. Gamma S, gamma, and then you're able to distinguish the color. So this is gamma D. So can you fill up the equality or any gamma S? Gamma S greater than gamma, greater than, if it is steeper here, so many times I told you it is a height versus temperature, not temperature versus height. Gamma S less than gamma, gamma. So, gamma lies between gamma S and gamma D. Okay, what happens to the story now? Okay, let us say that the parcel is lifted all the way. Okay, it will follow the dry adiabatic lapse rate up to the point A. So point A is now the, point A is LCL, correct. Now this fellow is at this point, he rises further. When he rises further, he will follow which slope? Gamma S. So I'll do some tricks now. So, gamma S is here, watch. So, I will move the notebook like this. He is following like that. Okay. What is the funda there? This is parallel to this. Correct? Now, at a particular point, this fellow cuts that gamma curve itself. Okay? He cuts that gamma curve. Gamma is the surrounding air and the parcel is starting from O. Okay, he cuts here, and so that point where it cuts is called LFC, level of free convection. Okay. So that point, let us call it as B. When it crosses here, the situation is different. Are you getting the point? When it crosses B, the situation is different. The white line is coming to the right of the orange line. Okay. So, you can write down in telegraphic language, consider a parcel O that the parcel O cools dry adiabatically up to the point A. If you want, you can write down in telegraphic language, the parcel at O cools dry adiabatically up to the point A, which is the LCL. So, the parcel at O cools dry adiabatically till it reaches A, which is the LCL. Point number 2, further lifting produces cooling at the rate gamma S. Okay. I put point 2, you said point 1 and 2?
Yes.
Okay. Please insert point 1A. What is this? Air. What is this? Originally that pink color is the parcel. Point 1A is at point A. At point A, the parcel is cooler than the surrounding air. Agreed? Very much clear, right? Correct? Vivek Kumar Gupta, is it fine? At point A, orange line is the parcel, sorry, pink line is the parcel, orange line is the surrounding air. At point A, parcel is cooler or colder, what did he say?
Colder.
Okay. Cooler. Okay. Point A is cooler than the ambient air. Okay. Point 2 is over. That is, further lifting produces cooling at the rate of gamma S. Point 3, if the air is sufficiently moist, if the air is sufficiently moist, the saturated adiabat If the air is sufficiently moist, the saturated adiabat passing through A will cross the temperature sounding. My reference point is orange line. Will cross the saturated, what did I say? If will cross the temperature sounding. Amit, you got it? Which will cross, if the air parcel is sufficiently moist, the saturated adiabat through A will cross the temperature sounding here. It may not happen always, sometimes the way we have drawn it, it happens. Point number 4, point of intersection is B. Point 4, the point of intersection is point 4, right? The point of intersection is B. 0.5. Above B, the rise is automatic, it is not under your control. Above B, the rise is automatic. So, what is the story? If, what is the story of the conditional stability? If gamma s is less than gamma, is less than gamma d. So, if gamma s, you can write down, if gamma s is less than gamma d, vigorous convective overturning will occur. If gamma s is less than gamma d, vigorous convective overturning will occur. If forced vertical motions, vigorous convective overturning will occur if forced vertical motions lift the air parcel beyond LFC. Okay. If gamma s is less than gamma d, vigorous convective overturning will occur if forced or induced vertical motions are strong enough to lift the air parcel beyond LFC. Okay. So, if you are able to achieve this up to B, then it will be violent convective overturning will occur, there some weather will occur, I mean weather phenomena may occur. Is it okay? So, this is as far as conditional and convective stability is concerned. So, analogy is, so you know this, right? Stable, unstable, neutrally stable, correct? Neutrally stable is, if you don't trouble it too much, it is all right. If you trouble it up to here, it is okay. It will come back. If you push it beyond this, it is not always stable. That is all right. I mean, I won't say neutrally stable, conditionally stable. All right. In our air parcel, this is represents the LFC. It will again go nuts if it crosses the LFC. All right. Now, the potential for the instability is also related to the vertical stratification. Now, let us look at some more advanced concepts. I am considering a layer of the atmosphere AB, okay. What is the problem with the layer AB? Temperature inversion takes place. That means generally with high temperature will decrease. AB is little funny, okay. So something is happening. So this is called a inversion layer. That can take place in the atmosphere for various reasons, okay. Let me plot the dew point temperature on the left hand side. Okay. So, here Okay. So, there is more moisture. I think I am not, the slope should be slightly. Okay. So, no, it's okay. It's all the same, huh? Forget it. So, here it is more moisture, here it is less moisture. Now, watch the arguments. I have given you the sounding. The temperature generally decreases in the inversion layer AB, the temperature increases. After the inversion layer, it again becomes normal. However, the dew point temperature rapidly decreases with height in the inversion layer. Did you draw it like that? I am supposed to have drawn. Okay. The dew point temperature rapidly decreases with height and in the layer AB, and B represents the top of that layer and A represents the bottom of that layer. Watch there. Okay. Now, the layer B, the layer AB is the air parcel, and now you are lifting. The air parcel is getting, air parcel means let us say it has got this height of AB and it is getting lifted. Now, the air parcel at A will reach the LCL very quickly because it is more saturated. But at B it will not reach LCL that fast, but they are together, it is the same air parcel. So, it leads to complication. So, an air parcel starting at B will cool dry adiabatically through a deep layer before it reaches its LCL. Are you getting the point? If you divide into several layer or strata, each of these you can consider an air parcel starting from this layer, air parcel starting from this. So, an air parcel starting at A will reach the LCL much faster than an air parcel starting at B, basically because of the inversion and basically because at point A it is more saturated compared to point B. Therefore, when the inversion layer is lifted, the top cools more rapidly because the top cools dry adiabatically, whereas the bottom, after it reaches the LCL, it has to cool following the saturated adiabat. The top cools more rapidly than the bottom, and what happens is the lapse rate gets disturbed. So, sufficient lifting can cause this whole layer to become conditionally unstable. Okay. So, basically leads to instability. So, what is the criterion for this? Dou theta E by dou Z positive, so in the exam if I ask you a question where I give you the height, where I give you the pressure and the temperature, and I also give you the dew point, so at each of these levels you will find whether gamma S less than gamma less than gamma D for conditional stability, gamma less than gamma D for unsaturated air, saturated air. So that problem will take half an hour for you to solve. One problem is going to come in the NSEM. So if we want to get conditional, if we want to get this conditional and convective stability, there is no other choice but for all those layers you have to get the LCL and the LFC, and whether the LFC is within that, LCL and LFC are within that layer, and all that you have to do. The alternative is to look at the theta E and find out for the inversion layer whether the theta E, dou theta E by dou Z is negative. Are you getting the point? So, so long as you are below the LCL, in the first few layers, the T is less than TD, the first few layers you can just use desi thing, gamma less than gamma D, gamma greater than gamma D. Then wherever the inversion occurs, you have to use more fundas. Then you will have to look at the convective stability, which is given by this dou theta E by dou Z. But throughout large areas of the tropics, the theta E, dou theta E by dou Z is negative in many places, but the convection is not breaking out because sufficient lifting is not taking place to release the instability. Are you getting the point? I will come again. In many places in the tropics, this condition is satisfied, but we do not see so much rain that instability and the weather activity is not taking place, basically because the other condition is we should have induced vertical motion where this parcel is lifted beyond the level of free convection, then vigorous overturning will take place. Okay, do not get into all this in the quiz, in the exam. In the exam what I will do is I will give you a sounding. Sounding means it will be typically like this. Station A, pressure 1000, temperature 30, dew point 21. Station B, 970, 25, 21. Station B, station C, 900, 18, 16, 800, 16.5, like that. Then I will ask, are the layers A, B, B, C, C, D stable, unstable or in neutral? Which layers are convectively unstable? So if you have to have convective unstable, if you have to find something is convectively unstable, what do? You have to find the LCL, you have to find the. So I will decide for, if you want to solve this full question, it will take 40-45 minutes. Okay, or I am asking you to just not worry about the convective stability. Out of this 7 points A, B, C, D, E, F, and I will say whether A, B, B, C and C, D are stable. I mean, I do not know, it depends on my mood. Okay. Otherwise, the full problem will be to look at the stability of the whole sounding. Okay. And there will be fun when there is an inversion which is taking place. Okay. It is well within your limits. Theta E, you know how to find out. Or theta E, I have given equation. I have given an equation for you. So you can find the theta E for that layer. So it will be highly involved if you have to get into the convective instability. Okay. Is that clear? That completes this chapter. I mean, in atmospheric thermodynamics, first law, everything is over. We will have to do the second law from tomorrow. Since Carnot cycle and all that, you know, we will quickly go through all this Kelvin Planck statement, Clausius statement. Then we will get on to the Clausius Clapeyron equation, which links the latent heat, okay, which concerns the latent heat, because latent heat is important in the atmosphere.